Hi students, hope you are all well. Now we'll see some quotes. One touch of nature makes the whole world kin, by William Shakespeare. Love the trees until their leaves fall off, then encourage them to try again next year, by Chad Seck. Importance of trees. Trees provide us with many benefits necessary for survival: clean air, filtered water, shade and food. Trees give us hope and courage to preserve even in the harshest conditions. So plant conservation is important. Now we'll move on to the lesson: transportation in plants and circulation in animals. In this lesson, you are going to study about how water, minerals, food move from soil to the plant and composition of the blood. You see herbs, shrubs, trees. They take water and mineral salts absorbed by the roots, reach all parts of the plant through the xylem. The food synthesized by leaves and it is taken by phloem. Translocation. The bulk movement of the substances through vascular tissue is called translocation. Transport. Carry things from one place to the another. Materials are carried by diffusion and active transport. Diffusion. Movements of molecules in liquids and solids from a region of higher concentration to lower concentration without energy is called diffusion. The next one is active transport. Active transport. It utilizes energy. It is carried out by membrane-bound proteins. These proteins use energy to carry substances across cell membrane, and it is referred as pumps. Pumps can transfer the substances from low concentration to higher concentration. The next one is osmosis. Osmosis, movement of solvent or water molecules from the regions of higher concentration to the lower concentration through semipermeable membrane. Osmosis is a passive movement. Active transport means from lower to higher. Osmosis means higher to lower. Plasmolysis. Water moves out of the cell and it results shrinkage of cell membrane. So water moves out of the cell. When water comes out of the cell membrane become shrinked and they are shrinked. Imbibition. Imbibition means, now we'll see imbibition. You are sowing the seeds in the soil and sprinkling the water. What happens now? The seeds started to absorb the water and they are swelled up. Then after some days it will started to grow. So here the seed is the solid. Solid absorbs water and swelled up. You can see it in the example in the dry seeds or dry grapes. The next one is the root hairs. Already you studied in lower classes, the root is divided into three types. Diffusion. What is diffusion? Solid or liquid molecules move from higher concentration to the lower concentration. So diffusion means solid or liquid molecules move from higher concentration to the lower concentration. This is the root tip with root hairs. Here, the region of maturation, the cells will mature. The next one is the region of elongation. Then, region of meristematic activity. And the root hairs is covered by a root cap.
The root cap prevents the root hairs from damage. Tears of root showing the movement of water from soil to xylem. Water moves through xylem. This is the root hair cells, cortex, xylem vessels. Water enters through the root hairs. First point. So water enters through the root hairs. The concentration of the water molecules in the root hairs will be more than that of cortex. Then these are the xylem vessels. Movement, types of movements. The movements is divided into two types: apoplast pathway and symplast pathway. Apoplast pathway means water occurs through the intercellular space and walls of the cell. Apoplast means water occurs through the intercellular space and walls of the cells. Symplast pathway means water occurs through the cells. Take a potted plant, then cover it with the plastic bag. You can see the next day water drops is present in the plastic bag. This is due to the transpiration. So transpiration means evaporation or loss of water through stomata in the leaves. Transpiration is an important question. Evaporation or loss of water through stomata in the leaves. So stomata are the small holes or pores present in the leaves, and they are covered by guard cells. And this is the bag. This is the guard. This is the stomata. Stomata in open condition, stomata in closed condition. Vacuole is present and it is covered by cell wall and nucleus is present. So stomata will open in the morning time. Stomata will be closed during the night times. Night time. The next one, opening and closing of stomata is due to the turgidity of guard cells. Opening and closing of stomata due to the turgidity of the guard cells. So what happens now? Water is lost. During evaporation, water is lost. The pressure is created at the top. The water is enter into the xylem. From that it will pass on to the mesophyll cells, and this is called as transpiration pool. Transpiration takes place due to external factors and internal factors. The external factors are temperature, light, humidity and wind. External factors are temperature, light, humidity and wind. Internal factors are number of stomata present in the leaves, percentage of stomata in the leaves, then water status in the plant, then canopy structure. Internal factors are stomata, number of stomata present in the leaves, percentage of stomata, then water status in the plant, then canopy structure. These are the internal and external factors of transpiration. Importance of transpiration. Transpirational pool for transport of water. Then they supply the water for photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means in order to prepare the food materials. Transport the minerals from soil to all the parts of the plants. It cools the surface of the leaves by evaporation and it will maintain the shape. So transpiration pull for transport the water. Then supply the water for photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means in order to prepare the food materials. Then third one, transport the minerals from soil to all the parts of the plants. Then cools the surface of the leaves by evaporation. Then it will maintain the shape. The next one is the root pressure. Ions transport through the vascular tissue. Vascular tissue are xylem and phloem. So ions transport to vascular tissue of the root. Then water increases the pressure in xylem. And this is called as root pressure. Again I'll say, ions transport to vascular tissue of the root. Water moves and increases the pressure in the xylem. And this is called root pressure. Even the plants also need the minerals. Minerals from soil for nutritional requirements. All minerals cannot be absorbed by the roots. All minerals cannot be absorbed by the roots. Two factors. Minerals in the soil are charged particles. So they cannot move through the cell membrane. Cell membrane means outer membrane of the cell. Then second one, concentration is very low. Minerals of the root. So they need energy in the form of ATP. ATP means adenosine triphosphate. So plants need energy in order to store in the form of ATP. Now translocation of minerals ions. Minerals are remobilized from older leaves to younger leaves. Minerals are remobilized from older leaves to the younger leaves. Example, deciduous plants. The minerals needed by the plants are phosphorus, sulfur, nitrogen, potassium are easily mobilized. Phosphorus and sulfur are easily mobilized, but calcium are not remobilized. Phloem. Phloem will transport the food materials. The phloem tissue is composed of sieve tubes, and sieve tubes have sieve plates. Phloem transport food materials. Then food will reaches the plant parts like leaves, buds, stem and other parts of the plant. The direction movement of phloem will be upward or downward. And this is called bidirectional. Sometimes the movement of unidirectional in xylem and upwards. So xylem upwards, but in phloem upwards or downwards, that is called as a bidirectional. Translocation of sugar. The mechanism of translocation of sugar from source to sink through pressure flow. Hypothesis. Glucose is prepared during photosynthesis. It is converted into sucrose. The sucrose moves into the companion cells, then into the living phloem sieve tube cells by active transport. This process produces hypotonic condition. Hypertonic condition means higher in phloem. Then water moves to the xylem and then to the phloem by osmosis. As osmotic pressure builds up, the phloem sap moves towards the area of the lower pressure. By active transport, sucrose moves to the cells, and here the sucrose is utilized and stored. As sugar is removed, the osmotic pressure decreases and water moves towards the phloem. The upward movement of water and minerals from roots to different parts is called as ascent of sap. Important question. The upward movement of water and minerals from root to different parts of the plant is called ascent of sap. This is the transpiration creates, transpiration pulls, and here adhesion and cohesion makes a column of water molecules. Capillary actions results in the upward and up water to the base of the stem. Then here osmosis pushes the water to the root hairs. The root pressure pushes water to the stem. So first the osmosis pushes the water to the root hairs. The root pushes the waters to the stem. The factors play important role in the ascent of sap, and it takes in place in the following steps. The first one is the root pressure, capillary action, adhesion and cohesion of the water molecules, cohesion, adhesions and transpiration pull. First one is the root pressure. Water from soil enters to the root hairs due to osmosis. So the root pressure is responsible for the movement of the water to the base of the stem. Water from soil enters through the root hairs due to osmosis. The root pressure is responsible for the movement of water at the base of the stem. The next one is the capillary action. Water or liquid rises in the capillary tube because of physical forces. This phenomenon is known as capillary action. Then adhesion and cohesion of water molecules. Water form a continuous column in the xylem because of the force of adhesion and cohesion of the cohesion. Cohesion means the force of attraction between the molecules of water. The force of attraction between the molecules of water is called cohesion. The next one is the adhesion. The force of attraction between the molecules of different substances is called as adhesion. The force of attraction between the molecules of different substances is called as an adhesion. The water molecules stick onto the xylem because of the force of adhesion. Transpirational pull. Transpiration through stomata creates the vacuum, and which creates the suction is called as transpiration pull. Transpiration through stomata creates a vacuum, and which creates the suction is called transpirational pull. The transpirational pull sucks the water column from xylem tubes, and thus water is able to rise to great heights, even to the tallest plants. The transpirational pull sucks the blood from the xylem xylem tubes, and thus the water is able to rise up great heights even in the tallest plants.
Blood. Next we will see about the blood. Blood is the main circulating medium in human body. It is a red color fluid, connective tissue. Components of blood. The blood consists of two main components, the fluid plasma and form elements, that is blood cells, which are found in the plasma. Plasma is the alkaline containing non-circular substance, which constitutes about 55% of blood. Organic substance like proteins, glucose, urea, enzymes, hormones, vitamins and minerals are present in the plasma. Now, blood cells are divided into three types: red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets. Red blood cells are otherwise called as erythrocytes. White blood cells are called WBC or leukocytes. Blood platelets are called as thrombocytes. Now we'll see about the RBC. They are the most abundant cells in the human body. RBC are found in the bone marrow. Important one word, RBC are formed in the bone marrow. The RBC is red in color due to the presence of respiratory pigment called hemoglobin. Matured mammalian RBC do not have cell organelles and nucleus. They are biconcave and disc-shaped. Their lifespan is about 120 days. RBC is involved in transport of oxygen from lungs to tissues. Important one word, matured mammalian RBC do not have cell organelles and nucleus. White blood corpuscles. White blood corpuscles are colorless. They do not have hemoglobin and are nucleated cells. It is found in the bone marrow, spleen, thymus and lymph node. Important question. WBC is found in the bone marrow, spleen, thymus and lymph nodes. They are capable of amoeboid movement. The white blood cells are grouped in two categories. Granulocytes, agranulocytes. Granulocytes na B-E-N. Agranulocytes na L-M. Granulocytes na B-E-N na basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils. Agranulocytes na lymphocytes and monocytes. Now we see granulocytes. They are contain granules in the cytoplasm. The nucleus is irregular or lobe. The granulocytes are three types: neutrophils, eosinophils and basophils. Neutrophils. They are large in size and have 2 to 7 lobed nucleus. The corpuscles form 60 to 65% of total leukocytes. Their number are increased during infection and inflammation. Eosinophils, it has bilobed nucleus and contains 2 to 3% of total leukocytes. Their number increase during allergy and parasitic inflammation. It brings about detoxifications of toxins. Basophils. Basophils are lobed nucleus. They form 0.5 to 1.0% of the total leukocytes. They release chemicals during the process of inflammation. Agranulocytes. Granules are not found in the cytoplasm of these cells. The granulocytes are two types, lymphocytes and monocytes. Lymphocytes are about 20 to 25% of total leukocytes. They produce antibodies during the bacterial and viral infections. monocytes. They are largest of the leukocytes. Important one word, monocytes are the largest of the leukocytes and are amoeboid in shape. Their cells form 5 to 6% of total leukocytes. They are phagocytic and engulf the bacteria. Next one is the blood platelets. Blood platelets are thrombocytes. Blood platelets are thrombocytes. They are small and colorless. They do not have nucleus. They are about 2,50,000 to 4,00,000 platelets in cubic mm of blood. Lifespan of platelet is 8 to 10 days. They play important role in clotting of the blood. Platelets form clot at the site of injury and prevent blood loss. Functions of blood. This is the important question. First one, it transports the respiratory gases. Respiratory gases means oxygen and carbon dioxide. It transports the digestive food materials to the different body cells. It transports hormones. Next one, it transports nitrogenous excretory products like ammonia, urea and uric acid. It is involved in protection of the body and defense against disease. It acts as a buffer and helps in the regulation of pHe and body temperature. pH means that alkaline medium. It maintains water balance in the body. So 7 points. First point, respiratory gases. Second point, digestive food materials. Third point, hormones. Fourth point, nitrogenous excretory products. Fifth one, protection of the body. Sixth point, buffer and pH. Seventh point, water balance.
Natural organization of animals, we have to mark Roman letter 6, 7, 8 and 9. I am sending the answers for you, copy down. This week homework, read Roman letter 6 and 7 and write the test.